under the 2016 NGO Act. NGOs are prohibited being partisan and engaging in fundraising for campaigning to support or oppose any political party or a candidate for elective political office. The State Minister for Internal Affairs, Obiega Kanya, warned NGOs of their obligations ahead of the elections.
Not engage in fundraising or campaigning to support or oppose any political party or candidate for any appointed office or elective political office.
The minister adds that defying the regulations could cost NGOs dearly.
Not interfere in the governance of the country. You see, governance is bestowed upon an elected institution. An elected institution according to the constitution. So all of us, others, NGOs and so on, who want to make a contribution must do so within the constitution and the laws which are available.
However, different NGOs expressed divergent views on the matter, saying that there was a chance that the rules could be misinterpreted by the government.
Over the past period, the sector has witnessed negative narratives and verbal attacks from senior government officials towards the sector. Most recently, media reports quoted the president referring to CSOs as mercenaries.
Well, it depends again. Are you funding political parties? Are you funding a particular person? I highly doubt whether we've seen quite a number of those NGOs. But again, you can't stop individual people belonging to particular parties. Because if I said, okay, fine, I belong to the NRM, am I going to be castigated? Or it only happens when a person is going to identify with a person in the opposition.
The whole thing is that most of the state actors, especially those who act at the district level, including the representatives of the head of state, the RDCs, don't seem to appreciate the role of civil society in as far as executing Article 38 of the Constitution is concerned, which talks about the right to participate in the governance affairs of your country.
Today's dialogue was called to improve the working relationship between NGOs and government. Statistics by the Internal Affairs Ministry show that there are 2,207 vilified NGOs out of more than 14,000 NGOs that were previously screened to operate in Uganda. Ivan Chimuchigozi, NTV.